You know, I was actually contemplating about something. Something that I wanted to take some time to think about and process. Something that actually happened yesterday. But before I begin, good morning and happy hump day, everybody. You know, this is... You know, hump day would be the sort of day I would tell a story like this. So, yesterday, an old friend of mine had messaged me and asked me a very peculiar question. It's peculiar in the sense that I know how to answer it, and obviously I did. But it actually took a lot of time to think about. Like, I know what I'm going to say, but how am I going to be able to say it? And remember, because of the whole social distancing thing, whatever, you know, on the computer, you know, all I can just do is, you know, type in whatever it is I want to type in, and hopefully my friend won't think anything wrong about it. So, I've given it some thought, and I eventually answered the question that my friend had asked. Now, you guys at this point are wondering, what on earth did she ask you? Oh, yeah, it was a she who had asked me. And she had asked me why I make videos. I guess it's been a pretty good long while since I've taken the time to answer this question, and you know, now that I've had time to really think about what I said yesterday, you know, it gave me the time to process it and therefore elaborate on why it is, you know, I do that. So, as a good portion of you all most likely know, this started off as a New Year's resolution on January 1st, 2018. It was really just simply, you know, I was going to make a video every day. Simple enough, right? Nothing too complicated or strenuous, you know. And don't even expect much of a budget because all it is just me talking in front of a camera. Simple, in retrospect. Now, why I started doing it outside of the New Year's resolution is, you know, let's be honest, we live in a society where two of the big things that are constantly being talked about, constantly being possibly ridiculed or praised or both, are social media and entertainment. Both of which, luckily enough, I actually really like to talk about. I mean, I've been doing videos as of right now for 815 days. Of course, there's a lot I want to talk about and say at this point. You know, again, I love that social media, while it does have its problems, you know, is a platform in which, you know, friends can get together and communicate. I love that, you know. I'm talking to friends and my brothers from Trinity Pauling, some family, in ways that, honestly, I never would think was possible. Which is ironic, considering that for the longest time I told myself I would never have a Facebook, which I do. So, that happened. And, you know, with entertainment, I mean, come on, entertainment's been a part of pop culture since the very beginning. I mean, entertainment existed long before I was born. It continues to exist now, and it's going to continue long after I'm gone. That's just a fact of life. Plus, combine that with the fact that, you know, I have a lot of stuff to talk about. Pretty simple that, you know, why not do it? I mean, in the end, what really was stopping me from just simply, you know, trying this myself? And plus, if anything bad happened, I would just simply stop doing it. Again, simple. Now, I should probably elaborate on what would constitute as quote unquote bad, because bad really is subjective. I mean, we have a concept in which we believe that something can be so bad it's good. And thankfully my videos really shouldn't fall into that category. At least, you know, they shouldn't. Now, also, when I think of bad, I mean, bad stuff that's, you know, happened to me, and some bad things have happened to me. I mean, again, the most recent, I just lost my grandfather on my mother's side of cancer. And not a day goes by where, you know, I don't think about him. You know, that's bad. But I think what people are really thinking about is, you know, what bad would constitute me legitimately stopping making videos, that is. And that's the fact, like, if these videos, me making these videos every day, is legitimately causing me some form of genuine misfortune, then I would stop. Now, you guys are probably wondering, well, what would count as misfortune? I mean, like, somehow, in some way, shape, or form, me doing these videos, like, embarrasses, like royally embarrasses my good name, you know, tarnishes my good name, you know, embarrasses my family, you know, possibly, like, I doubt it would ever happen, but something that would, like, causing genuine harm to people, and I doubt, and thankfully, none of that has ever happened, especially that last part. So, there really was no reason for me to stop. Plus, let's say that something that people would, but again, being embarrassed is also subjective. I mean, what one would constitute as subjective, what one would constitute as embarrassing, maybe I wouldn't think as such. I mean, again, that sort of thing hasn't happened yet. Not even close, even. Now, one could constitute that as, oh, well, you're just not taking any risks. And by all accounts, you're right. I don't really take any risks. I mean, I won't go so far as to say that's not entirely true. I mean, there was this video of me jumping into Keuka Lake where I'm wearing nothing but a swimsuit. I mean, some people may find the fact that I'm just wearing swim trunks, you know, gross, I guess. But that doesn't really embarrass me. Plus, let's be honest, it's 100 million times better than me just being naked on camera. No one ever wants to see that. And I'm never going to do that, so already that's a good sign for things to come, right? So, honestly, if I were to deem it as bad, like embarrassing or wrong, or it just makes me feel so incredibly bad, it puts me in just a position of depression and woe, then there's no need for me to stop. There really isn't. I mean, I'm obviously, I doubt this would ever happen either. If making videos was in any way a detriment to my health, then, well, obviously I would stop. But even then, that would sort of be subjective too. Like, come on, how is me talking to a camera going to get me sick? That wouldn't make any sense at all. I mean, ever since I started, I mean, the closest thing I could even remotely get to that is maybe I could potentially become obsessed with making the video, but even then, I don't even feel that way at all. So it's all good. Plus, there is another thing that does, in fact, legitimately keep me from not doing it. That, you know, I will make videos every day. Now, I should explain this as well. It doesn't happen that often. It really doesn't. But really, that isn't really up for me to have it happen. It's really up for the likes of whoever watches, I guess. And that is, on occasion, I'll get someone who comments, or message me or messages me saying, you know, I like your videos. You did a good job. You made my day. You know, good things. And I don't know about the rest of you, but whenever you hear something like that, you're actually doing something that's making people feel good, feel positive. It allows them to move on with their day or make their day even. I mean, it not only confirms that you are doing something legitimately right, but whenever you do something like that, it just makes you feel good on the inside. And that is awesome. So, yes, that's ultimately why I do it. I guess, have I ever really thought about stopping? Actually, no. Not really. In fact, you know, if I could do more, I would. I mean, again, I gotta get me a budget. I mean, don't get me wrong, talking in front of a camera is entertaining. But if you really wanted to see something, you know, that's on the more entertaining side, you know, somebody help me out. I don't really know how to go about doing it, but, you know, it wouldn't hurt. Plus, again, you know, you don't think I take enough risks? Well, maybe with the budget, you would see more of that. I don't know. Although, one thing I should probably explain, and this is my final topic about it. What if I, and this has happened too, because some people have actually told me that, you know, I shouldn't do it anymore, or maybe I should just stop altogether. You know, surprisingly, no one's ever actually gone up to me and said, I don't like what you do. You know, surprisingly, no one's ever said that, which I guess that's good for me. You know, hopefully. Watch, I'm going to get like a whole plethora of messages saying, you know, I don't like what you do. With my luck. But if you really felt that way about my videos and the fact that I make them every day, you don't really have to watch them, you know. Honestly, one of my all-time favorite internet reviewers was the Blockbuster Buster. He still does stuff. It just doesn't really come out very often. And he has what's called a blacklist. It's a list, if you will, obviously, of movies, video games, like stuff that he will purposely not spend a single cent of his money to entertain or watch or any of that stuff. Some of those things include the Human Centipede movies, the Michael Bay Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, all of the DCEU movies after 2017, like, those are the things he will not watch, he won't talk about, he won't review, any of those things. And here's why. When you talk about someone's work, whether it's in a positive light or a negative light, you are still giving them press. You are still telling the world about what that is. It could be a bad movie, a bad show, whatever. You're still giving them press. If anything, when you talk about them in a negative light, you make your audience ask the question, is it really as bad as, you know, that guy is making out to be? So they go out and look at it themselves, thus giving that thing you're making fun of even more power. So my advice, if you really don't like what I do, just don't watch. It's not really going to hurt me necessarily physically. You know, it shouldn't hurt you to simply stop watching my videos. If you like what I do, by all means, keep watching. If you don't like what I do, don't watch. I'm sure you'd find other ways to entertain yourself. Nothing stopping you from doing that. I mean, no, there's nothing stopping me from not making videos anymore. But honestly, because of what I said earlier and how occasionally I will get a message saying to me that, you know, I made them feel good or I made their day. I mean, come on, how do you stop after hearing stuff like that? So, yeah. Thank you to my friend who asked me why I make videos every day. Or what made me start making videos every day. Thank you. Gave me some good, careful reflection. I love it. So thank you. Like, favorite, share, hit the subscribe button. Follow me on the social media platforms. Turn on those notifications on YouTube. You know, be sure to comment if you want to. I do whatever. I do read the comments. You know, I am very humble. I made this video for all of you guys watching. Enjoy for today. And hopefully you all have a wonderful, wonderful hump day. And remember, if you guys want to talk to the channel, I'm always going to be here to lend an ear. I'll always have your back. Take care. Make good choices. See ya.